So can you just open your Kali Linux once? You have the access to the Kali Linux. Right now you have the Kali Linux. We'll be showing one practical for you. See, there is a running configuration file. So for the prerequisite is I required a running configuration file. Okay, because I have my own running configuration file. So I want you to run your own configuration file and see what are the vulnerabilities present in your organization or in your device or in your switches. So is it okay for you? Like, did you have any access to that configuration file right now? Or shall I show the procedure so that you can practice afterwards? Yes. So can you, I'm just opening my Kali Linux. Okay. Yeah. So I'll be showing the procedures and also I think based upon our procedures, so you have to prepare a report, executive summary report of your own these things. Okay. You have to put your own vulnerabilities as a manager point of view, okay, executive summary point of view. So you have to mask your IP address and then you have to share me. Okay. So I'll just show you the procedure how to do that. Because like when we go for audit, no. So always like a audit will tell us, sir, now it is having a very good traffic actually. It is a huge traffic. So you should not run the tool, sir. You should not do anything, sir. So please sir, you do, sir, as part of offline. So we told okay. So we as part of this thing, so we there is a procedure. So suppose if you have a running configuration file, suppose there are some 1,000 devices are there. There are some 1,000 devices are there. If you have the access to that 1,000 device, so you obviously have the running configuration file. Okay. The thing is like you have to save your format into the .txt. .txt. Okay. So suppose there are n number of switches are there. Okay. So that means like switches.txt. Okay. And routers.txt. Okay. Firewalls.txt. Okay. Gateways.txt. That means I should have all the running configuration file. Okay. I'll be showing one procedure. Let's just please be online. I'm just sharing my this virtual machine. So I'll be showing you my virtual machine. I think I'm sharing my let me just please give some time to me to on my virtual machine. Share application. Virtual, yeah. So can you able to see my screen from the chat? Okay, perfect. Yeah. So do you have access for the virtual machine right now? Okay, Ajay, let me just show you that. Yeah, I will be showing you that procedure, sir. I think no need to worry. So I'm logging to my root machine, right? So by default, when you install a root Linux, I mean like Kali Linux, okay. So I think it is in Kali Linux. So I think you have the idea about the Kali Linux, right? Kali Linux is one of the OS which is in a Debian format where you can have the n number of all the tools are embedded in the as part of VA, as part of PT, as part of scanning. Everything is imported in that Kali Linux. Okay, so it is in Kali Linux, the OS, right? So I think you are aware about this Kali Linux, yes or no? Kali Linux. So are you aware about those things? Yes or no? Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, perfect. So I think the default will be the username will be. Yes, will it be updated then and there, sir? Will it be updated then there, sir? Yes. So Srinivas, sir, what exactly you are asking? I'm not able to understand. Will it be updated and then? Yes, we will be giving you that what we say like a Kali Linux VM, sir, if possible, or if you give the link also, let me just give you the directly the link. So it will have your what we say like here. This is the one of the thing actually. Okay. So yes, I think yeah. I'm just sending you that link actually. Yeah. Yes, I think Naveen has forwarded. Kali.org downloads. Okay. So there you can go and you can download it. Okay. Download it. So the default username will be your root and the password will be tour. Okay. So these are the default credential when you install your this Kali Linux. If not, we'll send you that the VM or the how to user manual for how to install. See, there are two ways are there. One is you can install the directly the VMDK file, or there is a .ova format. Okay. So .ova format or .iso format is also there. So through which you can install that these things. Okay. So let me just show you that demo part. Okay. So I think I'm just showing, shall I show you that procedures? Okay. Think, are you, I think, yeah, door. So just login. Can you able to see my this thing right screen? So now my can you able to see my screen rise? Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. So for doing these things, so I have this configuration files, right? So for the time being, what I will do means I'll just rename it to, it might be any IP address, right? So in my case, my IP address, can you tell me what is my IP address here? I'm just opening my .txt here, text editor. So how many members have the basic idea to take that running configuration file? So I think you know how to take a running configuration file, and there are some network admins are there. You have to request them, and you can take in a one folder and you can keep on your desktop, right? So can anyone can tell what is my IP address by seeing my configuration file here? I'm just coming down. Okay. See, this is my configuration file. Okay, of my switch, where all I configured all my IP version 4, IP version 6. And I have enabled the CDP, I enabled all NTP, so all kind of stuff I have enabled, right? Okay. So can you tell me like what is my IP address in my case by seeing my configuration file here? Yeah, so Naveen sir has told 10.2.1.2, correct. So where exactly you have seen, sir, that my IP? Whether by seeing my the file name you are told like it is a 10.2.1.2, correct? That is a 10.2.1.2 only. Okay. So these are the these things are there. So if you want, so you can go to your terminal and you can just give the command show running config. I think you are able to see my dot text, right? TXT format. Are you able to see my these things, right? Okay. Are you able to see my running configuration file on my screen? Naveen, Srinivas, yes, Nagalakshmi Garu, I think yes, okay. So can you tell me like what is the version I'm using in my case? Sir, this is Cisco switch. Yes, it is a Cisco switch. Yes, this is a switch, Cisco switch. Can you tell me what is the version I'm using here? Yes, Kanika has told 16.6. Yeah, Naveen, Srinivas. Yes, correct, 16.6. My iOS is 16.6. Srinivas or Naveen? Yeah, Nagalakshmi, 16.6. Correct, madam. Anyway, you told like there is an iOS version 16.6. Can you tell me like... can you predict or can you tell me what exactly a 16.6 is vulnerable to? Can you tell me your iOS version 16.6 is vulnerable to what kind of attacks? Can you tell me? Suppose if you are necessary, if you are using, okay, I agree. But there are some chances, there is some BC, there is a DR setup. So where a compulsory auditee will say like, sir, you should not do the live scanning. Okay. Sometimes live scanning, something will go down. So your network will go down for some minutes. Okay. So at that time, so as a manager, as a CISO, there should be always in your mind, like you have to, there should be some tool with name as offline configuration audit, right? So can you guess, can you tell me like what is the basic vulnerabilities you use? I mean, like what are the vulnerabilities it has? You cannot tell, right? And you cannot tell, right? But seeing the iOS version, you cannot tell. Okay. So today we'll see like if you have a running configuration in your hand, so you can also see what are the vulnerabilities, and also the vulnerabilities ke saath, what are the recommendations you are giving to the client. Okay. So we are giving to the entire organization. Okay. See here, my NVRAM is current updated, and as you told, there is a version 16.6 is there. Okay. And can you tell me what is the host name here? What is the host name here from by seeing my configuration file? What is CGGM? Yeah, correct, correct. Yes, perfect. So by seeing my host name, can you guess? Yeah, Neha, correct. Srinivasan sir, correct. Yes, you are perfect, madam. So yes, can you tell me any way you guess my host name? So can you just tell me any host name vulnerabilities? I mean, like any, whether I am any vulnerable to some kind of host-based vulnerabilities. Can you guess? You cannot, right? By seeing the configuration, by seeing the these things, you are not. Unless and until you something you are there, whether you have a checklist. Okay. So I am today we'll be discussing on two points. One is through your what we say like tool base. Okay. And another one is your what we say like through manual checklist. Okay. So in my case, it is a CGG ZMZR. Okay. So what is yeah. So yes, password all caps, brute force attack, correct, madam. I think something I mean like it's some that means you are suspecting these are some of the brute force attack, right? Yes, correct, Kanika. Okay, so now we'll see like anyway we'll be I think you are aware about this, all those things. I just closing my configuration file. See, if you have a configuration file right now, so that we can practice what are the commands I tell you, execute your side and see what are the vulnerabilities are present right now in your switches. Okay. Otherwise, you can follow afterwards. Okay. So I'm just closing this thing. Okay. So this is my desktop, and this is my configuration file where exactly I am using. Okay. So here I'm just clearing the screen. So CD. Okay. So where is my file here? Can you tell me where is my file here right now? Where is my file? On desktop, right? So what I have to do? What I have to do for changing my directory? What is the command? CD. Tell me the full path. CD. CD space. Where is my destination? Where is my file on the destination? Yes, perfect. CD desktop. Okay. LS, enter. Okay. So what is the next command to list the file? LS, correct. Okay. So can you able to see my configuration file of switch, right? Are you able to see my configuration file on my desktop, right? So with name 10.2.1.2, correct? Yes or no? Yes, correct. So yeah. So yeah, there is a one command actually. Just drag my terminal here. So see, this is my command, nipper. So nipper is one of the tool. Yes, correct. Cat 10.2.1.2, correct, Srinivas. Have you ever seen this tool name, or whether you heard this tool name any of your time? Okay, so Nipper is the by default tool which is already present in your Call Linux. Okay, so Call Linux, so Nipper. So I just type Nipper here. Okay, hyphen hyphen iOS hyphen switch. Okay, so this is my this is my template actually which I am using for my to find out the vulnerabilities in my what we say like in my switch. Okay, okay. So hyphen hyphen input, what is this in hyphen hyphen input? What, why I am giving this hyphen hyphen input? That means my input file name I am giving here. Okay, hyphen hyphen input equal to 10.2.1.2, right? Few members are not able to install Call Linux, sir. I'll show you that also, sir, like as soon as this completes. So I'll showing where exactly the members are, yes, I'll explain that. Yeah. Yes, otherwise, shall I explain first Kali, then we'll go for the Nipper otherwise?